So we are going to discuss about the Chinese cuisine. So when you see in Indian cuisine, you can see that there are different types of ingredients, different types of dishes, varieties of food habits, lots of cooking processes are there. Okay, there that is very hard to memorize. But when you divide it into by their regional categories, like for Punjabi region, Punjabi cuisine. For Bengal region, Bengal cuisine, that is very easy to memorize all of the specialities. Okay, so just like Indian cuisine, Chinese cuisine also divided into 5 regional categories. Categories are Canton cuisine, Beijing or Mandarin cuisine, Shanghai cuisine, Sichuan cuisine, Hunan and Jiang cuisine. So in this video, we are going to discuss about their specialities and their special dishes. Okay, started from Canton cuisine. Speciality of Canton cuisine: live and fresh fish and seafood cooking. Okay, first of all, the consumption in this cuisine, consumption of fresh seafood and fresh fish more than the other cuisine. Second, the cooking process: they cook their seafoods and fish alive. Okay, third, mild sauce and ingredients. The sauces and the ingredients which are used for cooking are very mild, just because of they just need the raw and the fresh taste of the fish and seafood. So they are using mild ingredient and mild sauces. Okay, just because of it is not dominate the raw taste and the fresh taste of their ingredient. Okay, special dishes: shark fin soup, steam whole fish, roasted suckling pig. Okay, so it's all about the Canton cuisine. Now we are going to discuss about the Beijing or Mandarin cuisine. Okay, speciality: preference of wheat. Yes, in Beijing cuisine, people consume wheat products more than rice. Okay, so they prefer wheat more than rice items. Peking duck accompanied with steamed buns. Okay, this Peking duck accompanied with steamed bun is very popular in whole China. Okay, this is very popular dish in whole China, but the origin of this dish is Beijing or Mandarin cuisine. Okay, so that's why it is a speciality of this cuisine, this Peking duck accompanied with steamed buns. It is originated from this cuisine, but it is popular in whole China. Second, jiaozi is special Beijing dumplings. Okay, just look like momos. And Mandarin, the meaning of Mandarin means not only Beijing cuisine. Okay, suppose Peking duck accompanied with steamed buns. Okay, it is originated from Beijing cuisine, but it is not popular in whole China. Okay, so that's why we use this word Mandarin. Okay, so that is belong for this Peking duck accompanied with steamed bun is Mandarin dish. It means it is not only famous in Beijing, it is famous in whole China, but it is originated from Beijing. Okay, so that is the meaning of Mandarin. Okay, special dishes are mushu pork. Okay, jing jiang rosy. It is a pork dish, shredded pork dish. Okay, pork cut into shreds. Jing jiang rosy. Next, noodles with soybean paste. Okay, so special dishes are mushu pork, jing jiang rosy. Jing jiang rosy is a shredded pork dish, noodles with soybean paste. So it's all about the Beijing and the Mandarin cuisine. So now we are going to discuss about the Shanghai cuisine. First, speciality of the Shanghai cuisine. First thing is cooking process. Cooking process, which are very popular in Shanghai cuisine, are baking, steaming, braising, steaming, deep frying, etc. Okay. Next, drunken. Drunken is a style of cooking in which spirits are used. Okay, at first they added the spirit with the main ingredient, which is maybe fish, maybe chicken, maybe crabs. Okay, they added the spirits with the ingredient and cooked it in steaming process and served raw or without any accompaniment. Then sauces are rich. Okay, the sauces which are used for cooking are very rich in flavor. Okay, just because of their reduction process and the slow cooking process. Next thing is uses of sugar. Okay, sugar are the main ingredient of the Shanghai cuisine. They use sugar not only as a sweetener, they use it and add it with the soy sauce, okay, which gives a distinct and sweet flavor which enhance the flavor of the dish. Preference of rice. In Shanghai cuisine, they prefer rice item more than noodles and wheats. Special dishes are drunken style chicken, sweet and sour pork, etc. Next, Szechuan cuisine. First speciality of Szechuan cuisine is food preservation. Food preservation process. This preserve food by pickling, salting and drying process. Next, preserved foods are served in hot and spicy flavor and cooked with chili oil and using of peppercorn. Okay, first of all, if you see in Kolkata, there are varieties of Chinese specialty restaurants. Okay, there when you order a Szechuan chicken, maybe Szechuan pork, okay, then when you order the dish, they serve a hot, very hot and spicy flavored dish. Okay, so that is not the fault of the restaurant, that is the speciality of Szechuan cuisine. The speciality is they serve hot and spicy foods. Okay, they cook most of the dishes with the chili oil and the peppercorn, which gives a distinct spicy flavor to the dish. Okay, so that those are the speciality of Szechuan cuisine. Special dishes are mafu tofu and kung pao chicken. Next, Hunan cuisine and Jiang cuisine. First, the speciality of the flavor. Okay, flavors are hot, sharp and salty. Okay, the dishes, the flavor of the dishes are hot, sharp and salty. Major crops are citrus fruits. Citrus fruits mean which gives the sour flavor. Okay, like a lemon, tamarind, oranges. So those citrus fruits gives the sour flavor to the dish. So those are the speciality of Hunan cuisine. Special dishes are Hunan orange chicken. Okay, hot and sour glass noodles, Hunan spicy beef, hot and sour fish soup, etc. Okay, so that is all about the Hunan cuisine. Guys, I have a request to you that after completing my lecture, please go through with this, that is BNG food production handout. So find the chapter Chinese cuisine. There you can see that there are some Chinese and Japanese terms. Okay, so what you have to do, that is, at first read the chapter carefully, then memorize those Chinese and Japanese terms.